welcome back to GGTV, and more specifically, welcome back to a very, very obscure random video. I'm going to be honest with you guys and girls, I've got 15 minutes to film this video because the England game is on in 15 minutes and this car is around for a limited time. More on that on JE here, my twin brother's Instagram, okay? So if you're not following him on Instagram, get in the pot and he'll explain where this car's come from. But anyway, he's just turned up in this very, very, very cool and rare, apologies for the wobble there, I was just folding my screen, very, very rare. Ah, the football's about to start, isn't it, mate? Okay, so he's turned up in this Techart Turbo S. Haven't you, mate? Talk to me, what's going on here? This is really, really cool. There's some very cool features. Shall I go around them and point at them, mate?
Yes, yes, yes. Well, do you want me to point and you talk?
We can do that. We can do that.
So you've got a carbon insert on the front bumper here.
Carbon insert on the front bumper here.
Not standard, mate.
That's like the GT3s, etc. GT2 RS. They all have that vent there, though, the GT cars, which the Turbo S doesn't usually have. And that does look very, very cool. We like that a lot.
And then everything else is standard, wheel-wise, brakes-wise, all that kind of jazz.
Standard. Not such a bad thing. What else have we got, mate?
Carbon air intake there. Not wrapped. Actual carbon.
Mate. Not wrapped. Actual carbon. Major key.
And then the back of the car is probably where the biggest telltale signs are. So you've got this oversized carbon, actual carbon lip at the back, or spoiler, on top of the aero kit.
That's very, very cool.
And then you've also got,
I like that,
underneath here, this ducktail, which I actually really like. When you stand back from the car, it looks really, really good.
Oh, yes. We can see that.
Yeah.
We like that. And then obviously the brake lights are all integrated works properly in there.
And then, not that you can tell necessarily from here, maybe underneath. I don't know, mate, if you can, but it's got the Techart exhaust system, which we'll show you a little bit about in a minute.
And some sort of...
If you film, you can hear the difference when I open the valve.
There's some sort of hootenanny going on under there. Yeah, get in. Yeah, mate, go on, mate. Yeah, football's on soon. Hurry up, mate. Yeah. It's coming home, mate. It's coming home.
That's standard.
Okay.
And then if you turn the car here, they're not normally valves on the Turbo S.
Yep. Ooh.
Revs lad or no revs lad?
Give it a little bit of revs, mate, but I'm going to get petrol on my face, so you do watch out for that. Ooh, maybe a little bit more, mate. That's pretty punchy. As we all know, Turbo S's don't really sound very good, so that is actually very, very cool.
It's wired up until the integral, the sports plus and comfort here, so I can literally just...
So what are you saying there, that the valves go on and off with...
So that's off.
Oh, awesome, yeah, so my Carrera T actually does that with that, so that's all integrated Integral. Still.
Because it doesn't like actually have a sports exhaust button, because the Turbo S's don't normally have a valve system.
Ah, I didn't know that. So my Carrera T has actually got, for those of you at home that do not know this, my Carrera T, I think it's actually there, it's got a valve button there, which opens the exhaust. The valves do open automatically with the Sport Plus thing, and it turns that button on automatically, but the Turbo S's don't usually have that, so... With this little switch here, you go from comfort to sport plus to individual. The valve's open, that's very, very cool. And we've got carbon on the steering wheel here. I believe you can spec that from Porsche though. Yeah, the interior is really, really cool actually. It's just very Porsche. I do quite like it.
It works.
And you've got sunroof as well, which is very good. And obviously in the GT cars, you don't get that. You've also got, importantly here, you've got Burmester speakers, very, very cool. You've got carbon inlay. You've also got this kind of two-tone blue, which is really, really nice. White dials, and then all importantly in the back, red seat belts. I don't know about that. Don't know about that, mate. Don't know about that. But yeah, we've got seats in the back, which is actually really, really cool, considering this thing 0 to 60 is probably near enough a 918, pretty much, for all intents and purposes. But that is seriously, seriously cool car. You enjoying it, lad?
Do you know what? You just get in it and drive it, and it's so easy, yet it's so capable. Honestly, like, I can see why people...
Next car? In fact, is this yours?
Get in the comments.
Get in the comments, but also make sure you're following him on Instagram, because he causes chaos on Instagram. Yeah? This is... Yep, go on.
Or GT3 RS. I don't know. Maybe get in the comments. I don't know.
This or a GT3 RS, because they are about the same price now. Gen 1 GT3 RS is around the same price as this. This is going to be, what, 160, 170, I would say, maybe?
Oh, yeah, hard to price with the Techart stuff. Old Dean Redline, who I've collected the car for, by the way.
There we go.
There we are, for the avoidance of doubt. If you're not following him, why not?
Yeah, get involved. Shout out to Dean Redline.
So I don't know what he's going to price it at, but I've never seen another Techart one. This is the first one I've seen, and it looks just so much nicer.
Yeah, it does look cool, doesn't it? Because the Turbo S has always been accused of being a little bit boring. Mm. But this, it's got just so much presence is overused, isn't it? Can't really say that. But it's got that extra little bit of spice. And I'm not usually a fan of modifying cars, especially not Porsches. Not a fan of it at all. But this does just kind of that little bit of zing that makes it look better. Can you put the aero kit out at the bottom?
Yeah, you can, but the only thing it doesn't have is the external aero kit here.
Oh, it doesn't have that?
Maybe that might be overkill with the other parts, I don't know.
Yeah, so there is an aero kit option that has a little sort of vent there.
This
I believe.
Come out underneath. It's got the deployable turbo thing, but I'll probably mess it up on camera.
Yeah, I don't know how you do that. Apparently there's a little thing that can come out the front there. Go on, mate, get it out. Is it coming out? Oh no, it's going back in again. Oh, is it coming out again? I don't know where it is, lad. What have you done with it? Nah, we give up with that.
Give up, cancel.
But it's in there anyway. It's in there anyway, ladies and gentlemen. But it's very, very cool. Oh, I actually think you should probably try a Turbo S next. I don't know about going for the Techart stuff, because I imagine it gets probably pretty expensive. Mm. But you know ideas how much the kit costs?
Not a clue. Not a clue. Nor do
good.
I want to know.
Good, strong stuff. So power-wise then, you were saying to me earlier that this is actually the same. It's stock still, yeah. But obviously with the sports exhaust, it's gonna be sort of 10, 15, 20 brake or whatever. But there's no map, there's nothing like that, no?
No, it hasn't got the Techart ECU map as well, so it's a standard power plus exhaust when that is.
Okay, so that's gonna be... Nearly 600 brakes. So it's probably gonna be akin to the exclusive series that they did. Which is no bad thing. I mean, a standard Turbo S is no slouch. It's probably the quickest point-to-point car you can get. So that's pretty good. When are you replacing the 488? Should we have some talk on that?
I'm thinking around August, if I can make my mind up. But as you know, I dilly-dally and can't make a decision, so.
Okay. How do you think the football's going to go this evening?
Football is coming home.
Football. He's well, to be honest, by the time this video goes out, it might not be coming home. We might have gone out by
the
time this...
Let's think positive, lad.
Let's think positive. Nate!
Oh, I can hear jeering.
There's jeering. Started. The football is beginning. Any parting words, my lamb?
No, not really, other than the fact that it's if you don't like it.
Those are very nice jogging bottoms, I must say, actually. Can we get a close-up on those? Not on your buttocks, but on the jogging bottoms. Ah, we like those.
Pocket features.
If you want to know where to get these from, I'll leave the links below, and also we'll do the little Instagram pop-up on the screen. But there's a major... Are you okay? What's happening?
Features.
Features, yeah, we've got... Oh, those are nice calves as well, lad. Yeah, we'll have them. Anyway, that is that. We are lads, are we not? We need to go and watch the football because we're lads. England, Rooney, bring it home, mate, or whatever.
Okay. Name a player, quickly.
Steve Staunton.
Rooney.
Don't care. All right, that's that.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure.
Any parting words?
We're trying to get this in 10 minutes. About my football knowledge.
Football knowledge. You know, Steve Staunton came out of nowhere. Villa, I believe, in the 90s. Okay, so... Hugo Ekiog. God rest his soul. I think he passed away, actually. Okay, I'm going to have to put a 2-minute end slate on this anyway to get over 10 minutes. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this very impromptu vlog type car with this Techart. Make sure you do follow him on Instagram. I know I'm stressing that a lot, but he is causing mayhem at the moment. So do check him out. Anyway, thanks for watching. Subscribe, blah, blah, blah. See you again soon. Bye.